The hit series Wonderland is back on our screens, but we thought they could use a bit of a hand. So we sent in one of our best, Studio 10's creative genius, David Robinson. Let's bring him out. He's our reporter, David Robinson, along with one of the stars of the show, Tim Ross.
Thank you.
I liked your entrance, Tim. That was a very nice...
Thank you.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure how I was going to do it. I was thinking of facing the other way.
No, I liked it.
But Robbo tells me that's been done.
He's beautiful, isn't
he? Welcome to the show. Were you a bit surprised that we sent Robbo in? Did you think that there was anything really wrong with Wonderland?
I didn't. I didn't. But Robbo certainly showed me that there's... a lot of potential in...
There's room to move.
..in Jess's character.
Yep, there sure is. She's not really at the top of her game, so... You agree with that, right?
I'm confused.
Yes.
Well, maybe we should put it into context. On tomorrow night's episode, we get to see you being a bit of a naked chef.
We do.
Let's have a look.
You'll never believe who I just ran into. Q-Cow.
Oh, yeah? What happened? Did you apologise?
No, I insulted her again. But then I apologise, so I think I'm off the hook.
Ah. You still up for moose? Hmm? Sexy time.
Oh, yes! Give me a minute. I'll go get changed.
To nothing?
Into nothing. 70% cocoa.
Well... Okay to me, but what were your problems with that?
Well, I just think it needs more Robbo, really, in the scheme of things. So, yeah, let's have a look at it. Well, here I am. I've made it onto the set of Wonderland, and this is Danny and Steve's apartment right here. So let's just see if they're home. Let's have a little knock and see. Well, that's television. That door probably wouldn't be like that. Let's just see. Oh my God, Danny and Steve, it's you two. How are you?
Come on in.
Look, I want you to show me around. Now, obviously, Jess, you play Danny, and this is your apartment. Does your apartment look as nice as this one?
No. Danny has exceptional taste. I wouldn't say that my taste is that exceptional. And she's very colour coordinated.
I like the flowers.
Oh, decision made, like it is.
Obviously, Jess, tell me more about what else is real here because and what isn't real, because I understand I was looking at some beautiful photos of both of you on the fridge, which I just absolutely love, and I've pocketed a few, I hope you don't mind. But if we could just have a look now.
Inside the fridge, we've got fake beer, fake wine,
right,
fake champagne.
Yep.
That's the only downfall.
Yep, well, you used to have it in there.
On the outside of the fridge, we've got some photos. This is Jess as a little girl.
Jess, you adorable thing.
This is a photo of my sister and I at the MCG.
No, it's not. No, that's Jess, you and Jess.
You're quite correct, yes. Because they've taken my sister's head off.
Oh, my gosh.
And put Jess's on.
Forget about it. So now you're kissing your sister in a TV show. That's weird. Who's the biggest diva, really?
Jess.
Yeah. Wow, it's funny that you said both the same people. But pretend it's not either of you. Who else could it be?
Right. Got to be Ben Mingay. He's a massive, massive diva. Yeah. Stays in his trailer all morning, won't come out until his, you know, breakfast has been hand-cooked for him.
Mm-hmm.
He's a real piece of work.
Is there anything else you want me to do for you? Unless you want to squeal and paint my nails.
So, Tim, what do you do to prepare yourself for the role? Like, when you're getting started for a big day of shooting, what do you do?
Well, I like to work on the kissing scenes with Jess.
70% cocoa.
Because I'm a massive fan of the show, as you both know. And I'd really like to do a scene with you, like maybe an audition, maybe the producers are watching. So I was wondering, Jess, if you could leave us, and Tim, you and I will start to get Tim for the role. So I'll actually play you, Jess. So you'll just...
You want to play Danny?
Yes, I do. So if you could, it's been so lovely chatting to you. Thank you so much. Tim, I think if we should start preparing. Thank you so much, Jess. Tim, if you want to come... Yep, Tim, come with me. So I think what we do with the role, we should just really feel it, really get into it as if we're absolutely and totally and utterly in love with each other. You will never believe who I ran into today. You can.
Well, what happened? Did you apologise?
No, I insulted her again. But then I apologised and I think I'm off the hook.
You still up for chocolate mousse? Sexy time.
70% cocoa. Yes, babe. Okay, can we change it to something a little bit more comfortable?
Into nothing?
Into nothing.
Honey, are you ready?
Oh, Okay. Well, on the whole, I thought that was really good.
Thank you, Jess.
I really believe the love between you and Tim. That was.
I have a lot of love for Tim.
There was a lot of chemistry there. Yeah. I found that quite intimidating.
Well, actually. It kept happening as well.
Yeah, no, that was palpable.
Are you still in contract? Like, because maybe, I mean, there might be some other stuff that you could maybe explore. No, I wouldn't. I just think that Tim and I said had a certain chemistry that I think maybe is.
Yeah. Who do you prefer Tim? Working with?
There we go. Thanks for coming, Jess.
Very compelling, very powerful.
Although I noticed it's a show a different feel, doesn't it?
You didn't get naked with Robbo, though. I felt like you weren't really committed to the role.
I certainly tried, didn't I?
He asked a few times.
I did.
There was no kiss on the lips either.
No, but I was very excited when I felt you. Yep. Yeah. Sorry, I'm still remembering. Sorry, I just had a flashback.
I love Jess Tovey. I actually have a girl crush on her, but you were good.
Thank you very much.
You were really good. I could feel the love, for sure. And no kissing scenes.
No, look, we thought we're both at the top of our craft and we could portray our love through the screen without having to show something physical. But, you know, that can happen at any moment with Tim and I. Sorry, Tim. Tim and I. And all the time.
I really liked you as a brunette.
Do you?
Oh, yes. I thought your hair was wonderful.
And it was so full-bodied and just that turn and just... I hope the producers are watching. And you put in a good turn.
A good word, yeah.
Now, Tim, you are a fantastic sport. It is a great show. Back tomorrow night?
Back tomorrow night.
8:40?
Yeah.
What can we expect? Can you give us a little tease?
Well, you can expect a little bit of Megan Gale. On the show. Yeah. Whoa. A little bit of chocolate mousse, as we've just seen.
Ooh. And, is that the name of a character?
Chocolate mousse.
Yeah.
that's my character.
Tim Ross, everyone.
Thank you.
Make sure you watch him tomorrow night, 8:40, right here on TV.